Playing host to football for over 90 years now, we're at Camp Randall Stadium, the venue for today's game. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Right is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. Taken from the 3-yard line. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 24-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
Really good play here in run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 23. Let's go! Gets out to around the 35.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down. Especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 35. Throws into double coverage, and it's intercepted. He's taken down at the 45.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. Touchdown, Panthers. And he adds the extra point. Georgia State is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Oh, he got nailed on that one. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
It may be early, but don't think the coaches haven't spent a lot of time reminding these guys how important it is to take care of the football.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
Middle linebacker came on a blitz, which can be very disruptive. Sometimes a quarterback will get happy feet when they see that coming. Not this guy. He's very composed and can deliver under a pass rush.
From their own 45-yard line, it's first down. Got the corner. Got some open field. And they push him out around the 36-yard line. Him hard at the 27. That's good work. That makes it second and two. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Throw, and he's taken down right around the 22-yard line. First down there on a 5-yard pass.
Now, this is a good job by the wide receiver of making sure he was beyond the first down marker and then hanging on to that pass.
From the 22-yard line, first down. Bring him down at the 15. That'll bring up second and three. And he gets a yard on the run.
Call it a gain of 1 yard.
Third down. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Three down. Hey, check back the back.
Ready!
Looking for his man, incomplete.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Georgia State's offense deserves all the credit in the world. You come into a crowd like this, and they didn't keep them from doing the job at hand. They got points on that opening march.
Just really impressive. Considering this is, I think, one of the toughest environments in all of college football, that's a job well done. Now they've got to continue to try to build off of that opening drive.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play. So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. Georgia State holds a 4-point lead. Nice run there. Smith gains about 4 yards on the play.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 9.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. And he is drilled at the 19.
That makes it 4th and 9.
4th and long here after the sack. Wright is the punter. He makes it to the 45-yard line. The Panthers are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you talk to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on? And what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down like this.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Open receiver dropped.
Number 15 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. And they make the stop around the 31-yard line.
First down.
Houston with a nice play fake. Brought down at the 19-yard line.
Guys, I really like what the offensive coordinator is doing here. Throwing it on 1st and 2nd down to keep the defense guessing.
First down.
from the 19-yard line. First down. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 12. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A six-play, 45-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So our score, 10-7. Wisconsin ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
A bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Wants to go long and does.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. And down he goes around the 45-yard line.
It definitely put them in better field position. And I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
Play fake. Second and 10. Ball on the 45. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
Great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. It seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
He'll take it from the 18. Down at the 25-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Wisconsin holds a field goal lead. On play action, defense coming. Big catch there as they knock it out of bounds. First and 10. Ball on the 47. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
That'll make it second and 4.
At about the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, it's first down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
I love the blitz, but the quarterback did a really good job of seeing it and reading it, and then standing tall in the pocket to find his man for the first.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 7-yard line. Wisconsin is up by 3. Breaks a tackle and he'll score. Touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. One great kick, and it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. Interception, and he's tackled right around the 34. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Straight run here, and he's got nowhere to go.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
Coming to you.
Quick strike to the receiver. And he's all the way in for the touchdown.
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful. Brad, the quarterback and this wide receiver clearly have outstanding chemistry. Wide receiver is so open because it was a perfect route and the quarterback was able to time it up just perfectly.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25. He's taken down at about the 25-yard line. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Moves up, and the defense has got it.
Now, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Catches it, and they'll bring him down behind the line. Loss of three.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. To punt. And down he goes at the 42-yard line.
So the Badgers are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, and still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
Drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
And he's taken down at the 47-yard line. From their own 47-yard line, second down. Bring him down at about the 27-yard line.
Well, I tell you, these guys have some skill players who can make things happen. They picked up an enormous amount of real estate on that play.
From the 27-yard line, first down. Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work. Nice run up the middle.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. That's going to do it for the first half, and they're just trying to keep this thing close. Wisconsin's lead is 17. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Wisconsin's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, it's just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Smith gains about 5 yards on the run.
That brings him second and five.
Second down and five. Ball on the 30-yard line. He scrambled. Loose football. It's scooped up, and it's a lineman that's got it.
Close one there. Maybe the ball carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
And it's caught. And he hits him hard at the 38-yard line.
First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 38. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. He's under some heat. He's wrapped up for the sack. Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long. And the ball's popped loose. Wright awaits the snap.
Hit. He wasn't getting away from that one.
We're about set to start things up again. Quickly, he's got his man, and they make the stop at the 24-yard line. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Quick throw, touchdown, Badgers!
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all.
And he converts the extra point. A short two-play, 55-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Wisconsin, the kick. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Georgia State's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down, and they're forced to punt. Or their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in the game like this. Throw the ball downfield.
And it's intercepted. Oh.
First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 34.
He airs it out. It's broken up.
A lot of times you don't have time to react on a pass that is thrown into the end zone. So that was a very good job to get his hand in the way to knock the ball away.
And they need to get it to the 24.
Well, this secondary has to feel pretty good about locking down the receivers on that drive.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Check 11.
He's tackled around the 25-yard line.
What a boost it is for this defense, knowing that they kept the offense off the board. Although in this case, the offense kept itself off the board by electing to go for it.
Should be interesting to see how this affects the rest of the game. It's second and 10.
Ball on the 25-yard line.
Three down. Let's go. Here we got Mike.
Mike, three and five.
Motion.
He's on the run.
Has it to the senior. And a huge touchdown play. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. Quick two-play, 75-yard drive. But they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he'll return this one from the 7. Whoa, he just took a licking. Last time out, the offense wasn't able to convert on fourth down.
And this offense comes out on the field again after being stopped on downs the last time out. And not only does that affect them in a negative way, but you know what it does? It gives this defense that they're facing a ton of confidence and a lot of momentum as they come back out on the field.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Gets to around the 42.
Concentration to be able to come down with the ball and give this offense a huge lift.
First and 10, ball on the 31-yard line. Tackle made at the 14-yard line.
off in the end zone. That INT puts them in a position to make this a game.
Yeah, they really needed that. That's a huge boost to morale.
From their own 12-yard line, it's first down.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Third and long now after the sack. Up the middle for a nice game.
Didn't fool the defense at all. They dropped him before he had a chance to get close to the first down.
Wright is waiting for the snap. And he's taken down at the 38.
Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Receiving team.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. And gets out of bounds. That makes it first and 10. One more quarter to play. This one appears to be well under control. 31-13, Wisconsin. Clement gained 7 yards on that play.
That'll bring up second and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Find his receiver, and that's a first down. He's taken down at the 17-yard line. Falls incomplete.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. slings it, and he's tackled just outside the goal line. First down. Chance for three or seven here. First and goal inside the five.
Touchdown, Wisconsin.
And he tacks on the extra point. Wisconsin gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So the Badgers have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. He's under pressure.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Great concentration to pull it in. Brought down at the 48-yard line. First down. From their own 48-yard line. First down.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike. Number three. Mike,
quiet, Yank. Lost the motion.
And they got it.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush because sacks can be real drive killers.
That'll make it second and one.
Cavalry's coming, and the corner on the interception. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36. Wisconsin comes to the line in complete control in this game. Quick throw. Almost picked off.
Makes it second and ten.
All right, D.
Hey, check back 11. Check back 11.
Set. Green flag.
Throws and it's incomplete.
Number 11, the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. He heaves it to the end zone. Almost intercepted. What a huge break for the offense.
He had his hands all over that ball. He just couldn't bring it in.
Bring him down at the 19-yard line. From the 19-yard line, it's first down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Carries the ball for a nice game. This is
is the eighth play of this drive.
Just under three to go in regulation.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
From the 7-yard line, second down. They get in, touchdown. The defense hasn't been able to keep this guy from the end zone. He's got four scores.
We've wondered if the linebackers were going to be able to slow him down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 36-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injury.
He gets rid of this one.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down.
Smith takes it up the middle, and they make the stop at the 23-yard line.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
Just over 2 minutes in the game.
This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
Wright is the punter. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Wisconsin's proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
Runs it right. Nice pickup. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That'll make it third and one.
Tight right. Three down. Hey, check Mike 11. Let's go.
He's tackled around the 37-yard line. The 37-yard line. First down. Gets to about the 34-yard line.
Under a minute left in the game.
Fires out to his wideout. Good open field tackle.
That's good enough for Wisconsin. First down.
And he might want it all here, and does! The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
That makes it second and 10.
Converts the extra point. So a 7-play, 48-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line. Gets to about the 27-yard line. So that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, the Badgers 52, the Panthers 13.
And the Panthers 13.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.